In this video, we are going to see Skempton's, Hansen's, Meyerhof, Vesic and ice code methods. So far you know that there is a one method called as Terzaghi's method, which is used to determine the bearing capacity of soil. But there are some other methods also. For example, Skempton's method, which was given after Terzaghi gave his method in 1943, Skempton gave his method in 1951. He modified little bit of work from Terzaghi. Okay, after that Meyerhof came in 1952, he gave his own corrections. Hansen's came in 1961, then after that Vesic 1973, and our own IS code method is also there, which is we are using since 1981. So basically all of these methods are not part of Mumbai University syllabus, so you don't really have to worry about it. There are two methods that are part of your syllabus. First one is this Vesic method, other one is IS code method. So if you don't want to study all these three methods, so you can skip the video. Just go to the comment section. There is a timeline that I have given. You can just go over there and jump to Vesic method or IS code method. Okay, but I'll strongly recommend you follow the video throughout. It won't take much time, and having a little bit of knowledge more than what is required never hurts you. Okay, so please follow the entire video. We'll start with the Skempton's method, 1951. So the Skempton method is only applicable to the purely cohesive soil. So a clay soil which has a phi equals to zero, this Skempton's method is applicable to that. Okay, so Skempton method, net ultimate bearing capacity is given by a very short formula, that is Q net ultimate equals to CNC. It's a very short and sweet formula. Other thing about this Skempton's method is that the value NC does not depend upon the value of phi, because in Terzaghi's method we had seen NC, NQ and gamma depend upon the value of phi, but here NC depends upon the value of TF and the shape of footing. Okay, now for the stiff footing, the value of this NC equals to this. So because for the different, as it depends upon the shape of footing, for different shape, for stiff footing or continuous footing, you will have a different value of NC. For square and circular footing, you will have a different value of NC. For rectangular footing, you will have a different value of NC. So the first, for stiff footing, this is a formula given over here that is used for determine NC value. And the value of NC is restricted to 7.5 for value of DF by B greater than 2.5. So let's say if the ratio of DF by B is going beyond the value of 2.5, what you will do, let's say your DF by B is 3. So what you will do, just take the value of NC equals to 7.5. That's it. Okay. And for the square footing, you will have a different formula which is given over here. And this value is restricted to 9. Okay. So let's say your DF by B is, let's say, 2.6. So what you will do, just take the value of NC as a 9. That's it. For rectangular footing, the formula is lot more complex, and this formula is this NC equals to this big formula over here. L is the length of the footing, B is the width of the footing, DF is the depth of footing from the ground level. Okay, and this formula is applicable for DF by B less than 2.5, less than equals to 2.5. If this DF by B goes beyond the ratio 2.5, then you will have to use this formula. Okay. And one of the good thing about the Skempton's method, why it is still relevant even though we have different methods, because this method is applicable to deep foundation also. Remember, Terzaghi's formulas are not applicable to the deep foundation directly, but you can use Skempton's formula for deep foundation also. That's why it is still relevant after so many years. Next one, Meyerhof's method 1952. Now on the screen what you see over here is this is the zone in which the Terzaghi has divided the soil below the base of the footing. So I think we have seen this in part 1 of the shallow foundation series, zone 1, zone 2, zone 3. And one of the basic assumptions of the Terzaghi was that all these three zones are below the base of the footing. So if this level that I have shown you over here, FE, is the zone of the base of the footing, then these three zones will always remain below the base of the footing. But Meyerhof says that these zones may exceed beyond the base of the footing. So he has given additional zone that is called as a mixed shear zone. Okay, and this is your Terzaghi's formula, which is given over here, and the Meyerhof's formula is lot more bigger than Terzaghi's formula. Okay, and what are these values that you see over here? SC, DC, IC. These are called as a, this SC, SQ, S gamma are called as a shape factors. DC, DQ, D gamma are called as a depth factor. IC, IQ, I gamma are called as a inclination factor. Okay. Next, Meyerhof has also given different value of NC, NQ, N gamma. So for the NQ, you have to use this formula in Meyerhof, and this value N phi in this formula of NQ is nothing but tan square 45 plus phi by 2. Next is the value of NC, that is equals to NQ minus 1 cot phi. Now, other important thing that you should remember, whether it is a Meyerhof method, Hansen method, I-squared method, Vesic method, these NQ, NC and this N phi never changes. These value will remain constant in all the methods, and the value of N gamma will keep on changing depending upon the different method that you are using. For example, for the Meyerhof method, the value of NQ, N gamma equals to NQ minus 1 tan of 1.4 times of phi. Okay, and you don't really need to remember this formula, because most of the time this value of NC, NQ, N gamma are given into the numerical. If they are not given, you can either use this formula, or depending upon the method, you can also use this table. So this is one of the table for Meyerhof's. This value of NC and NQ will remain same for Vesic's method, for Hansen method or I-squared method. The only thing that will keep on changing is the value of N gamma, because we have different formula for N gamma in different methods. Okay, next, because what we have seen so far is, now next thing what we'll do, we'll find out the what are the formulas for this shape factor, depth factor and inclination factors. Okay, so let's see the first one, shape factor. Now there is not much to explain in this, so only thing that I'll do is I'll just show you the formula and do the whatever little explanation is required somewhere. Okay, so I'm just going to show you the formula. These are the formulas for shape factor in Meyerhof's method. Other important thing, this formula for SQ and S gamma is only applicable when your phi is greater than 10. If your phi is 0, SQ and S gamma is equals to 1. This is shape factor. These are the formulas for depth factors. Okay, again, different formula for DQ, D gamma for different value of phi. If your phi is greater than 10, you have to use this formula. If your phi is equals to 0, DQ, D gamma becomes 1. So there is not much to explain, so I'll just keep on scrolling here. Inclination factor. This one is little bit complex, so we'll do some explanation over here. Okay, so the inclination factor IC equals to IQ and equals to 1 minus alpha by 90 degree whole square. Now, the important thing that you should remember in whether it is I-squared method, Vesic's method or any method, this value of alpha is always measured with the vertical. Okay, So let's say in numerical it is given that the load is inclined at an angle 80 degree to horizontal. That means the value of alpha that you will put over here will not be 80 degree. It will be 90 minus 80 degree, that is 10 degree, because alpha is always inclined with the vertical. That is very crucial. Should remember, many people makes mistake over here. Don't make silly mistakes here. Okay, that is the value of IC and IQ, and this is a formula for I gamma. This straightforward, you need to remember the formulas. Okay, and this formula is applicable if your phi is greater than 10. If your phi is 0, your I gamma becomes 0. So this is all about Meyerhof's method. Next we'll see the Hansen method. Hansen method, it is important because this method is basically used in three different conditions, because Terzaghi's method cannot be used when your load is inclined. Terzaghi's method cannot be used when your ground is inclined. Same, it cannot be used when your footing is inclined. So in these cases, in practical application, you need either Hansen's method, Vesic's method, or highest code method. Okay, so Hansen's formula is same as Meyerhof's formula. The only difference is the value of n gamma. If you could remember, we had a different formula for n gamma in Meyerhof's method. You will have a different formula for n gamma in Hansen's method. Okay, this nq, nc is same. N phi is also same. And these are the formulas for this shape factor, depth factor, inclination factor. This is a formula given over here. I will not do an explanation over here. It is not required, unless there are some critical cases like inclination factor over here. This is a different notation. H is nothing but horizontal component of your load. Let's say your load is inclined, so it will have two component. One will be horizontal component, other will be the vertical component. So your H is nothing but this horizontal component, and your V is nothing but the vertical component. That's it. Okay, other thing is this delta is angle of friction between soil and footing. Ca is the addition between soil and footing. These are all, if it is given into the numerical, use it. And it is not part of Mumbai University syllabus, so will not worry about it. If you have any doubt, if you are not from Mumbai University, and if you have any doubt regarding this, you can always ask me in the comment section, because there are a lot of people watching this video which are not my student. Most of them are from abroad, so I was not expecting this, but as there are some people who are watching this, if you have any doubt, you can always comment or email me about this. So I'll not do any explanation. Okay, let's go ahead. This is important. This is part of Mumbai University. You have to pay attention here, over here, very carefully. Okay, so NQ, NC is same as Hansen's and Meyerhof, no changes. N gamma has a different formula here. You should pay attention to N gamma here. Very important. Okay. I just forgot whether I'm recording or not, so I'll just go and check. Please don't mind this. Yeah, recording. Thank God. Okay, so Vesic's method. You have a different formula for N gamma. Hopefully, if you are not having a very bad luck, these value of NC, NQ, N gamma will be given into your examination. If not given, please remember this formula. Okay. So the only thing that we are going to see next is this shape factor, because these will not be given. SC, SQ, S gamma, DC, DQ, D gamma, IC, IQ, I gamma. These values will not be given into your examination. You must remember this formula. These formulas are very straightforward. SC's formula is this. And if you could pay attention to this, these are the same formula that were used in Hansen's method. So let's not go into the detail. These formulas are very straightforward. Just remember them and use them. Okay. So other important thing that we should see is inclination factor, because inclination factor needs a little bit of explanation. So the first inclination factor, IC, this is the formula given, and this formula is applicable for phi greater than 0. So this is usually asked in our examination, where phi is always greater than 0. In a very rare occasion, it might happen that you have to use different formula for IC when phi is equals to 0. Okay, if phi is greater than 0, your formula is very simple, very easy. If it is equals to 0, this formula, where IC equals to 1 minus M by H, A, C, A, N, C, this formula, the value of M over here is this. This is again a very big formula, and there are two formulas for M to determine value of IC when phi is 0. First formula of M is this, where B is the width of the footing, where L is the length of footing, and it is applicable when your H, that is, remember, H is horizontal component of the load. If your load is inclined and it has two component, horizontal component and vertical component, if your horizontal component is parallel to B, then in the formula of IC, you will use this formula. If your H is parallel to L, then in the IC formula, you will use this formula. Okay, so this could be a little bit complicated. If you don't have enough information available into the numerical and you cannot decide, sorry, and you cannot decide whether your H is parallel to B or H is parallel to L, then don't worry, just use any of these formulas. The result will not be like very drastically different. There will be small variation and nobody will even notice where you made mistake. Okay, so just hope and pray that the value of phi which is given to you in exam is greater than 0. If it is not greater than 0, then you will have to remember this formula. Okay. Next, the value of IQ is, IQ and I gamma are given over here, where H is your horizontal component, V is a vertical component, A is the area of footing, CA is the adhesion value between footing and soil, and phi is the angle of friction, M we have just seen. Similarly, the formula for I gamma is given over here. Okay, and for say, for some reason, and if it is not given, this CA is, let's say this value of CA is not given into the numerical, what you will do, you will not just put the value as 1, don't worry about it. If the area of footing is not given, let's say width is given 2 meter, length is not given, so what you will do, assume the length as a 1 meter, this area will be equals to L into B, that's it. It's very simple, the only thing is you have to remember a lot of formulas, that's it. Okay. This is so far about all the methods. The next very important method that is asked in examination so many times, and probably it will be asked again this year or probably next year. This, sorry, I'm having a little bit of cough for a few days. So don't worry if you are wondering, it's not corona. Probably I'm having cold. Let's hope I'm having just cold. Okay. So, I-squared method, it is given in IS-6403-1981. This method is combination of all above methods that we have seen. Okay, so it's little bit easier as compared with other methods. In some way, it is little bit difficult. It totally depends upon you. Okay, so this is the formula. And if you could see the formula, the one new addition that you see over here, that is the value of W dash. Okay. W dash is given here. So, in addition to shape factor, depth factor, inclination factor, we'll also have to determine this W dash, which is nothing but water table factor. Okay. We'll see how to do it. It's not very difficult. We already seen it into the effect of water table part. So, if you have studied that, you won't find it very difficult. Okay, let's go ahead. So, and in I-squared method, you have two different formulas. One formula for general shear failure, other formula is for local shear failure. So, you need to pay a very close attention which type of failure type is given into your numerical. If if you have been given general shear failure, make sure you are not using this formula. If you have been given local shear failure, make sure you are using this formula only. It makes a lot of difference. you should pay attention here. Okay, next one, NC, NQ, N gamma. As usual, they are same, but the only thing is the value of N gamma. Hopefully, the value of NC, NQ, N gamma will be given into your numerical. If they are not given, you have to remember these formulas. There is no other option available. This formula for NC, NQ, N gamma, they are also given into the IS code. If IS codes are allowed in your examination, you can just go and use this table. There is a table on page number 8 in IS 6403-1981. In this, you can find out the value of NC, NQ, N gamma. So, I would say, to be on safe side, just remember this formula. Okay. Next, this is also given. I have found this table. This table is given in, as I said, IS page number 8 of IS 6403-1981. To download this code, I'll give you the link in the description. Go and see for yourself. Next, these are the shape factor for IS code method. As I said, it is little bit easier than other methods because you don't have to remember the formula, you just have to remember the values. So for the strip footing, which is also called as continuous footing, SU, SQ and S gamma are one. No need to worry about it. For rectangular footing, you have formulas. These are the formula, remember it. Square footing, these are the values, remember it. Circular footing, you have different values. You need to remember all of these. If possible, take the screenshot, or I'll do one thing, I'll just upload this PPT into your Google Classroom, and also I'll put this PPT into the description box where you can download it. Okay, so remember this shape factor table. Next one is a depth factor. Depth factor, I'll just give you the formula. I'll not do much explanation because there is nothing much to explain. Beside that, DC, DQ formula you have. This first formula is applicable when your phi is less than 10 degrees. If your phi is greater than 10 degrees, you have to use this formula. So now some people might ask, what if the phi is equal to 10 degree? Then it totally depends upon you. Use either of these values. There is no issue at all. Okay, depth factor is done. And inclination factor. This is very important. IC and IQ formulas here in front of you. And as we had discussed earlier, alpha is the angle between vertical and the load. Okay. And anything else in this? No. Okay. Fine. Let's go ahead. I'll not explain anything. It's very straightforward. Okay. So this is the last bearing capacity factor that we have to see. So this is called as a water table factor. Now you have seen that this is an additional factor that we need to consider in IS code method. So this, there are four different cases. The case number one is when your water table is below the value B. So this is P, your width, and if your water table is below B or exactly at B. Okay, in these cases, the water table factor W dash equals to 1. It means there is no effect of water table. This is we already seen in our video on effect of water table on bearing capacity. This is similar. Case number 2, when your water table is at depth TF. Let's say your water table is at this position. Let me rub it out. Okay, let's say your water table is at this level. In this case, your W dash will be 0.5. Case number 3, if your water table is at depth gamma Z. So this gamma Z is below the depth of, below the base of footing and above this distance P. In that case, you have to use this formula. W dash equals to 0.51 plus gamma Z gamma by B. What is Z gamma? Z gamma, remember, Z gamma is always below the base of footing but above the distance P. Now the case 4 is little bit complicated. If the water table is above the base of footing but below the ground level. That means if the water table is, let's say, over here, in that case the W dash will be 0.5, but the surcharge is calculated using average unit weight. Now what is the surcharge? This is the value of surcharge. How do we calculate surcharge? Surcharge is nothing but Q equals to, this Q equals to gamma into DF. Okay, so when you are calculating Q equals to gamma into DF, the unit weight, that is the gamma, should be gamma average. How do we take the average? Let's say your water table is somewhere over here. Okay, that means this unit weight above the water table will be gamma bulk, and the unit weight of water below the water table, unit weight of soil below the water table, will be gamma submerge. So let's say this DF is 5 meters. Okay, this DF is 5 meter and water table is at a distance 2 meter from the top. 2 meter from the top, I am giving you an example. Okay, it could be any value. Let's say this is water table from the top, it is at 2 meter. So this remaining distance is 3 meters. In that case, what you will do? Average. How do you determine the average? Average will be equals to this gamma bulk multiplied by 2 meter. This gamma dash, because remaining is 3 meter, gamma dash is 3 meter, divide by 2 plus 3. This is how you can determine the average unit weight. And your Q will be, this Q will be equals to gamma average multiplied by DF. This is how you can determine the W dash in these four different cases. Okay, so this is probably the longest video that I have made. There are a lot of formulas, there will be a lot of confusion. If you guys have any issues in understanding this, or if you find out that there is some mistake, there could be a mistake, because typing these many questions, I could have made some mistake. So if you find out these mistakes, please let me know, I'll correct it. Okay, and that's it for this part of the video. Next part, I'll try to take one numerical on IS code method or Vesic method. Probably on a Vesic method, I'll take one numerical, because IS code method is little bit easier than Vesic. Okay, so that's it for this video. You guys take care.